This is Hollywood Cemetery in Richmond, Virginia, above the James River. This is an area called President's Circle. And this is the final resting place of President Monroe. The last time I was here, I think this was black iron. Anyway, they painted it beige. Very impressive wrought iron work. And if you come up closely, you can see the brass plaque. The artwork, the mortuary artwork here at Hollywood Cemetery is of a very high grade. All sorts of impressive stuff to look at. You get impressive views of Richmond from Hollywood Cemetery. There it is on the James. Now we're looking at Belle Isle. It was once a federal, well, a Confederate prison camp for Federals. Those rocks are fun. I once had lunch perched on one of those rocks. Presidential Circle. Here's an impressive monument to John Tyler, President of the U.S. from 1841 to 1845. Died in the city of Richmond, 1862. You could see that the Tyler Monument and the Monroe Monument are very close together. And also, not far from another notable, Matthew Fontaine Maury. I believe he was called the Pathfinder of the Seas. Yeah, he was. Got that right. This one's sad. Meet me in heaven. William's grave, the beloved son of William C. and Annabelle Allen. In his 10th year, he died. I'm guessing there was a bust of him originally in that niche. It occurs to me that I could make a very long video about the funerary art here in Hollywood Cemetery. There's a lot of it, and it's quite good. Here are a couple of odd ones and interesting ones. The Ficklin family. They have those keyholes. Those three circular designs, those cutouts. Well, there's one there, and then there's another one here. Same thing, except a bit smaller. Died in Pasadena, California in 1978. And this is the marker of Henry A. Wise, a one-time governor of Virginia. Before the Civil War, an interesting character. Here's the resting place of another prominent man in Virginia politics, Jefferson Davis, the one and only president of the Southern Confederacy. I am very happy to see that there is no graffiti on any of this. It looks like the mobs have spared this area. Although there used to be a Confederate flag flying from that flagpole, there is not anymore. I think it's somewhat interesting that if you follow the gaze of Jefferson Davis across the way, you come across an obelisk that is dedicated to somebody in a Grant family. Ulysses S. Grant, of course, being probably the one man more than any who took down the Southern Confederacy, with the possible exception of Abe Lincoln. If you go this way, here's the obelisk of Fitzhugh Lee of Virginia, son of Robert E. Lee. And his son, Fitzhugh Lee, who died in 1954. And some others in the Lee family. Vice Admiral Fitzhugh Lee III, U.S. Navy. He died in 1992 and was buried at sea in the Pacific Ocean. It's the heraldic crest of the Lee family, whose motto in Latin is "Not unmindful of the future." Here's one in a more modern vein. Robin Lowe, died in 1995, gone shopping. Dream Girl. Number of items placed around. This impressive structure is known as the Confederate Pyramid. It's erected in 1869 by the Hollywood Memorial Association. It overlooks the burial place of a lot of Confederate soldiers. All these short white monuments, these are all Confederates. And here's a memorial to the Confederate women of Virginia. ...18,000 Confederate soldiers buried in and around here. And this is the last resting place of Major General George E. Pickett, who is known primarily as having led Pickett's charge at Gettysburg. I am guessing that there was once a Confederate flag flying here, but they took it down so as to not taunt the cancel culture types who could probably just hop this fence with cans of spray paint. And leaving Hollywood Cemetery, we pass by the Reese family plot, where we find a large cast iron dog. Near the dog is what I believe is the resting place of a child. Perhaps not. Maybe this was a beloved family dog. I don't know. The inscription is too hard to read.